Hi everyone. Good to see you. We're low in number today, but hopefully there'll be a few stragglers coming in and we can still raise the roof, can't we, even if we're low in number. So this summer here at St. John's, you know that we've been doing a series going through the Psalms. And today we're going to be looking at Psalm 105. So let's stand together and call each other to worship using some verses from that psalm. I'm going to say the words in white, and then if you speak out the words in yellow. Come, let's give thanks to God together, for our God always keeps his promises. Let's watch for signs of his presence among us, for our God always keeps his promises. Let's worship together in song then.
Amazing grace. This is unfailing love.
remain standing as we declare our faith together. Do you believe and trust in God the Father? Do you believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to
Do you believe and trust in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Amen. We're not having God instances in quite the same way today, so it's time for the kids to go out. So I think you know where you're going, that way to creche and that way to Sunday school. And let's just pray for them as they go out together. Lord, we thank you so much for our kids. We thank you, Lord, that you can meet with them as much as you can meet with us, Lord. And we pray that you would do that. And we pray that you would bless the leaders as well as they go, that you would strengthen them in their faith, that you would strengthen their friendships with the kids, and that you would bless their time together. Amen. Bit up and down this morning, we're up again for some singing as we continue in worship.
Thank you.
beautiful song. Let's take our seats as we get to the Bible reading, and that brings up some of those themes again in Psalm 105. Today we're going to read it responsively, so that means that I'm going to read the first verse in white, and then you follow with the second verse in orange, and we continue through the verses in that way. Psalm 105, verses 1 to 6. Give praise to the Lord, proclaim his name, make known among the nations what he has done.
Sing to heaven, sing praise to heaven, tell of all his wonderful acts.
Glory in his holy name, let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice.
Look to the Lord and his strength, seek his ears always.
Remember the wonders he has done, his miracles, and the judgments he pronounced. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Amen. So Ross is going to come and give us some teaching from this psalm, and as he does that, let's pray for him, and for ourselves and for each other. Lord, we just thank you so much for this amazing songbook and poetry book that you've given us as a resource to aid us in our prayers as well. And Lord, as we look at Psalm 105, I pray that you would stir things in us and help us to proclaim your name and to remember what we've been singing about, that you're a faithful God, Lord. And we thank you for what Ross has done in preparation, Lord. I pray that you would anoint him now and that words he speaks would be a blessing to us and help us to draw near to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thanks, Sean. Sean looking very well today. She's raised the bar. I'm my usual scruffy self, so apologies. It's always fun when we go out together. There's always like a discrepancy between the way we dress, but life goes on. In September, we'll be starting a new series looking at the life of Joseph. I'm repeating that each week because people are coming and going on holiday. So we'll be starting a new series on Joseph. We'll be looking at that till Christmas. I think God's got a few things to say to us from that story. But for the summer, we have been dipping into the Psalms. So we've been looking at the lectionary readings and particularly focusing on the Psalms each week. And today, we're in Psalm 105. That's where the lectionary has led us. But we're going to do things a little bit differently this morning. But we are. So what we're going to do is I'm going to briefly outline Psalm 105 to us. I'll go through it and just give you a brief sketch of what goes on. And then what we're going to do is we're going to each write down, think about, and write down something which we're thankful for ourselves. And then, with your permission, we'll collate those, and we're going to use those to produce our own psalm of thanks and praise to God. So Sonia will collect those. I've got about two or three further points while she's collating things, and then we'll listen to our psalm. All right? Understand? Don't worry, it'll all become clear as we go through, I think. So firstly then, Psalm 105. And it begins with this resounding call. So stir yourselves and let's resoundingly call each other by speaking out these words, all right? Yeah? Resounding call. Give praise. Give praise to the Lord. Proclaim his name. Make known among the nations what he has done. Sing to him, sing praise to him, tell of all his wonderful acts. Do you find even the act of speaking out those words does something inside? Just stirs something within us. It's good, folks, to speak aloud God's word. This isn't in my notes here, but it's good to speak it out aloud. A lot of us have been trained to speak internal voice, haven't we? So when we read our Bibles, we do internal voice. It's good sometimes to read aloud, even when you're on your own and you're reading your Bible. Read it aloud, because there's something about declaring it that does something in your heart. So there's a wee Brucey bonus for you there. Try that. So We're going to look at these verses in a little bit more detail later. But for now, notice that the psalmist calls people to praise God. He's like, come on, guys, let's praise God. Let's thank God for what he's done. And then the rest of the psalm, which we didn't read, it outlines reasons the psalmist thinks we should be praising God for. And he particularly focuses on God's faithfulness through the history of Israel. So that's his particular focus, but we can praise God for so many things, as we're going to do a little bit later ourselves. So he begins by going way back to the beginnings of the nation of Israel and the patriarchs. And he talks about God's dealings with Abraham, with Isaac, with Jacob. You know the story of how God protects these patriarchs and their families, and he leads them on a wee journey, and what happens is a nation is beginning to be born as God blesses and multiplies through those three generations and beyond. And then years pass, and the psalmist goes to the next sort of big episode in the history of Israel in verses 16 to 22 of Psalm 105. And he tells us about how God raises up this character called Joseph to rescue and defeat his people during a worldwide famine. We're going to look more on that story in September, so I'll not dwell on that for too long. So what happens is Joseph saves his people, his dad Jacob, his brothers, and some of the people of Israel come and they dwell in Egypt because the food's there, but then they stay there. And God multiplies them and blesses them, and the people grow and grow and grow. And they get so fruitful, as the psalmist says, that God made them too numerous for their foes. So the people of Egypt look at this multiplying people right on their doorstep, and they get worried. So what do they do? Let's have a bit of interaction. What do they do? What do the Egyptians do to them? They enslave them. They make them work for them. They subjugate them. And then what happens? Probably the greatest story in Jewish history. What happens next? Yeah, the Passover and the Exodus. God uses Moses to challenge the spiritual authorities over Egypt. You know those plagues? Each one of them is him challenging the spiritual authorities in Egypt and saying, our God is greater, our God is greater, our God is greater, until eventually their gods surrender and Pharaoh surrenders and the people are miraculously led out through the Red Sea and they begin their journey to the promised land. God comes through yet again in their history. Not only that, but verse 39 reminds us that God goes before the people and he leads them through the wilderness. He leads them with a pillar of cloud during the day and a pillar of fire during the night. Would you have loved to have seen those? Imagine. Wouldn't that be great? If you're not, some of you are searching for guidance in different issues. Imagine a big pillar of cloud comes and says, come this way, be class. Anyway, so God is leading them through the wilderness, and then disaster strikes. This is the psalmist is outlining all of these stories. He's just saying, look at this, look at this, look at this. So disaster strikes. There's no food and water. And can you remember what happens? Manna and water from the rock and quail. So yes, manna, quail and water from the rock. So verses 40 to 42, the people asked God and he brought them quail. He fed them with bread of heaven. He opened the rock and water gushed out. It flowed like a river in the desert, for he remembered his holy promise given to his servant Abraham. So the people yet again are cared for by God. They continue their journey, and after a generation, for reasons we'll not go into today, eventually they arrive at the promised land. Can you imagine? Can you imagine that generation as they step into that promised land? Now, of course, they had to take over the city of Jericho, thank you. They had to take over the city of Jericho, and then God stretched their influence from Dan the north to Beersheba in the south, and they took over Canaan. Now, the point of all this is that God is faithful. And that's why the psalmist tells the people, remember your history. Remember your history. Remember how God has proven himself faithful over and over and over again. And he stops at the point of them entering the promised land. But for each generation of God followers, we get our opportunity of writing about the faithfulness of God in our generation, because all of the generations are his story, history. They have a God at the center. They have a God who's faithful. They have a God who, if we'll look to him, will guide us as he did his people. So we're going to praise God for his works in our generation. And when you think about it, there's countless reasons to give thanks and to praise God. He's blessed us with life. We're here today. We're alive. As John Port will always say, I thank God for the breath in my lungs. That's his go-to phrase. And he's right. Right down to the basics. God has given us breath in our lungs. He's blessed us with provision. We've got clothes on. Probably most of us have had something to eat today. He's blessed us with salvation, with so much more as well. So gratitude and praise and remembering what God has done should become a holy habit. It should be part of who we are and what we do. Saying thank you, lifelong thank yous to God for his goodness and his unfailing love. So let's do it as a church family now. Hopefully, all of you have got a wee piece of paper and a pen. If you haven't, wave to Sonia there. And what I want you to do is to take a wee minute. I'm going to play some music, so you've got a wee bit of time, and think before you write. Don't be just writing something and thinking, oh, I've got a better idea. Have a wee think before you write, okay? And then write one sentence, one thing that you just want to look back over your life and say, thank you, God, for that. Now, it could be something very specific. It could be something like, God, you raised me up when I was ill. Something very specific like that. Or it could be something more general, like, God, you've looked after my family, and I can see your blessings in my family. But just think about one thing that you particularly want to say thank you to God for. And then write it down. Don't include your name. We're going to keep all of this anonymous. Just write down that one sentence of praise, and then we'll collect them in if you want yours to be collected in. So just have a wee think and have a write.
So faithful a friend so loving a King. Savior, what can be said? What can be sung as a praise of your name for the things you have done? Jesus, what can I give? What can I bring to so faithful a friend, to so loving a King? Savior, what can be said? And what can be sung as a praise of your name for the things you have done? Oh, my words could not tell, not even in part, of the debt of love that is owed. Of the debt of love that is owed.
Sonia's going to have a wee go at collating some of those. We'll not be able to read all of those, but she'll collate some of those into our psalm of praise, which we'll hear a little bit later. Three final thoughts before we return and listen to that psalm that we've written. Thought number one, if you look again at the opening two verses of Psalm 105, what we see is that praise and thanksgiving has a double impact. There's like a double positive whammy when we give ourselves to praise and thanksgiving. So first of all, what we see is that it testifies to others. In other words, it's evidence that comes from us, personal evidence that our God is good and that he's faithful when we speak about these things more publicly. So that's why the psalmist says, make known among the nations what the Lord has done. And I suppose my challenge is your praise and thanksgiving only done on the quiet, on the QT? Or do sometimes you just, when you're talking to your friends, you say, look, you never guess what God's done here. You know, I've been praying about this, and look, you don't have to be too weird about it. You could just say, you know, oh, I've had a great weekend because of X. I've been praying about this forever, and God came through. But it's a way when we talk about the goodness of God naturally like that, of testifying to him, to the nations. Let's just start with our friends, that would be good, or family. It's a way of testifying to his goodness. So don't reserve your praise and thanksgiving just to your quiet times, yourselves, but talk about his goodness to others. That's the first thing. It's good for others, but it's also, if you have a look at verse 4, praise and thanksgiving, gratitude, is good for us. It does us good. The psalmist says, look to the Lord and his strength, seek his face always. And that comes after the declaration of praising and thanksgiving. So when we do these things, it does strengthen our spirit. When we praise God and remember what he's done, if we choose an attitude of gratitude, I know that's overplayed, that phrase, but if we choose that attitude of gratitude, instead of muttering and moaning with the, yes, very real challenges we face in life, but if we choose to look for the good and say thank you to God for the good instead of muttering and moaning, it's good for us. We draw strength in our spirit. So it's good for others, it's good for us, thought number one. Thought number two, I think there's a further reason why it is significant that verse 4 reminds us to look to the Lord and his strength, to seek his face always. Anyone here last week? A few of you. His Reverence was speaking from Psalm 27. And I felt when he was speaking that God particularly emphasized verse 4 of Psalm 27. Also, let me remind you what it says. It says, one thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Listen, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord and to seek him in his temple. To gaze on the beauty of the Lord and to seek him in his temple. So both Psalms and both verse 4s, ironically, encourage us to prioritize and to pursue a relationship with God. And not just a wee glance, but to seek his face. To gaze on him. To really make him our all in all. To make him what we get up for. And my question to ourselves and to myself is, are you seeking the Lord? Are you seeking his face? Are you making him your priority? It's crucial for our spiritual growth. It's crucial for that sense of endurance, to be able to endure stuff that comes along. But is God our heart's desire? Do we just long to be with him and seek him out? Thought number two. Oh, note to self. Look to the Lord. Note to self. Look at when you're meant to change the PowerPoint slides. And then finally, thought number three. In verses 5-6, the psalmist urges us to remember God's wonders. So this is the message paraphrase. This is how the psalmist puts it. Remember wonders he has made. Remember his miracles and the verdicts he's rendered. Recalling the wonders of God in the past strengthens our faith in the present. Recalling the wonders of God in the past strengthens our faith in the present. So when we remember that we serve the same God who did those incredible things, like the Exodus, like raising up Joseph, like feeding the people in the wilderness with quail and manna and all sorts of things like that. And when we remember that's the same God who's with us today, it inspires us. So read the Bible, remember that it's the same God, and be inspired firstly, but also remember and recall what God's done in your life. When has God come through for you? I know all of you, I'm looking at your faces, and I can think of wee stories in your lives where God has come through. Well, remember those interventions. Remember when he's answered your prayers, when he's brought you healing, when he's provided a way where you didn't know, you were stuck, you didn't know how you were going to get on. When we regularly recall God's wonders in this way, in the Bible, yes, but also in our lives, it feeds faith in the present. So look back to feed faith to move forward. Three wee thoughts. That's a good lead-in to our psalm. So let's hand over to Sonia, and we'll use your compiled words to praise God together with thankful hearts. Maybe just close your eyes, okay? Because otherwise you're looking around to see people reacting. Just, this is about our collective praise to God. So just close your eyes, and let's hear that. And let's use this to give our own thankfulness and praise to him.
I'm actually going to use them all, because there's not that many of us here, and it's great, it's encouraging. Give praise to the Lord, proclaim his name, make known among the nations what he has done. Sing to him, sing praise to him, tell of all his wonderful acts. He created the beautiful mountains. We can see his power and care in all the creation around us, from great to small. We love to praise him through music. He equips and sustains us as a church family to do his work at home, in church, and in our community. We've got Wi-Fi. You've been shepherd all my life until this day. We praise God for his amazing love for us, how he forgives me and is there for me when I'm weak. He holds me and lifts me up. I'm so thankful for my children. God is gracious and has a wonderful sense of humor. We praise you, God. You met significantly with our daughter at just the right time and brought her back to faith. You provided all we needed for a wonderful refurbishment. We praise and thank God for his goodness to me and my family. Thank you for my beautiful family and for my loving family. He holds my hand through the storms and the calm. He gives hope to those in need when all hope seems lost. I'm just so grateful that he loves me. You have rescued me time and time again, brought beauty out of brokenness, shown mercy and grace, and blessed me beyond measure. He is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger, rich in love and mercy. I praise you, Lord, for knowing me before I was born. I thank you, God, for never leaving me, always being there when the going was tough. I look forward to the same in the future that you allow me. Thank you. You have looked after me through all the years and years.
You've stayed with me even when I have wandered from your presence. Thank you for your patience and love. He has given me health and strength to carry on in difficult times with loss of family members. He raised me up in times of illness and continues to do so. He sent his son to die for us and save us. He has brought friends into my life who remind me and show me his love in both good and difficult times. You lifted me up, Lord, when I was troubled and worried about my illness. You surrounded me with people who point to the divine and gave me windows that gave a taste of your peace. Look to the Lord and his strength. Seek his face always. Remember the wonders he has done, his miracles, and the judgments he pronounced. Praise the Lord.
Beautiful. Thanks, Sonia, and thank you, everybody. We'll type that out and send it out in the wee WhatsApp group. Maybe this week you could use that as our collective praise as you give thanks and praise to God yourselves. Let's stand together. Let's be a people who give thanks to and seek the Lord diligently. And as we get into this holy habit, because these things are habitual, when we do them, we begin to see the benefits of them and go back to them. So may our lives, as we do these things, be living testimony to God's goodness and his love and his grace. And may it draw others to him as we make our lives full of thanks, full of praise. Let's praise now as we sing. And we're going to have a couple of songs of response. And can I encourage you just to lift your hearts to God and use this time just to turn back what we've been thinking and praying about and offering it to God and saying thank you for all your goodness.
Empty-handed, I rejoice. You deserve. Thank you.
It's wonderful to think that God's grace is enough for all we need, all in the past and all in the future. And here come the kiddos. Hi, guys. Let's take a seat. Before we close, we've got a few notices. So, Family Festival is next weekend. Woo! Thank you to all of you who have registered. If you haven't registered and you are around and could come along, please do register. You can do that online. Have a look at our church family WhatsApp. Or there's some leaflets like this that say Family Festival on that you can fill in and give us your money. £10 for an individual, £20 for a family. Also, because we're buying barbecue and breakfast food for the Saturday and Sunday, please register as soon as you can so that we know how much food to buy. And also, could you sign up on the sheet here if you haven't already offered to help with something? We need food for the Friday night, and also we need various different things over the weekend. So please register and sign up. Thank you. And we're going to round off the Family Festival by going to see Dave getting ordained at Willowfield, which would be brilliant. They're not here today, are they? No. Okay, if you haven't signed their card or given us something for their gift and you want to, the card is right at the back. Walk until you can't walk anymore and then turn right. Oh, Ross is going to bring it up here. So please do sign that on the way out. And if you haven't given any money and want to and you haven't got cash today, because I know a lot of people don't get cash, just ping me a message and I'll put some cash of mine in for you and trust you to give it me later. Okay, then at the beginning of term, we've got Bishop's Bible Week, which I'm excited about this year. I met Greg Downs at a lay readers event that we had and heard him speak. He's an interesting guy, good speaker, and some inspiring personal testimonies. So let's all of us take the opportunity to come and enjoy his ministry at the start of this term and get us inspired for the term ahead. And then at the end of September, we've got another opportunity for worship and ministry, but this time it's just for ladies. I think most of you will have heard about it on the Bells WhatsApp group. So it's a new initiative for our diocese called Encounter, sort of a bit like what used to be Kingdom Women, but it's just for our diocese. So there's a brunch with worship and ministry on the 30th of September, and tickets are £10 each. These kind of events do normally get sold out, so if you're interested in going, then do get online and book that, or give me a shout and I'll buy you some tickets. Lastly, do remember our prayer challenge for this summer. I know many of you have taken that up, but let's be persevering in prayer for our friends. And if you don't know what it's about, come and chat to me or pick up one of these Pray for Five pledge leaflets, which is down there as well. Should we close while we're seated? Let's do that. Go from this place with joy, giving thanks to God, proclaiming his goodness, celebrating his love, and worshipping him with our lives. For he is the Lord our God, faithful to 1,000 generations. And may the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with us and among us today and in the days to come. Amen. Nice to see you. Do stick around, have a chat. Sign up and pick things up. Come for prayer ministry if you want at the front here, and hope to see you again during the week.